Hey guys, coming to you from the Museum of Transportation here in St. Louis, Missouri. And I thought you'd like a look at this 1941 Union Pacific Big Boy. And we'll take a look at it here. This is one massive machine. And of course, you got your cattle catcher up front here and your coupler and everything. You can see this is a UP 4006. You got your big light up front there, and of course your bell up top. But this thing weighs over 600 tons, so it is pretty massive. And this is what they call a 4884. You got your four wheels up front, and then you've got eight drive wheels here, and then a second set of eight drive wheels further back, and then another four wheels in the very back. But so, I mean, it is just really long. I mean, this is a pretty massive locomotive. Over here, they have a plaque that shows where it was built. Let me look here. So it was built by American Locomotive Company, September 1941. But, it is definitely an impressive machine. I mean, it doesn't have the most massive drive wheels or anything. I mean, some of them have drive wheels that are, you know, a little bit larger than this, obviously. But it is pretty big, and obviously it has 16 of them, so pretty cool. Here, while we're here, we'll go ahead and take a look at the specs on it. Union Pacific Big Boy. You guys can pause and read all this. It was built at a cost of $265,000 in 1941, and it's over 132 feet long. Very cool. And as you can see, it's got its original tender with it as well. It carries 25,000 gallons of water, so that's pretty cool. And they've actually got a stairwell here so we can go inside and check it out, so we'll do that. Alright guys, let's go ahead and take a look at the inside here. You see you got the brakeman's seat right here. That doesn't look very comfortable. Then you have the fireman's seat, the guy that actually tended the fire. And then you got your various steam pressure gauges and everything. And you got your injector controls here. Exhaust steam injector, it says. Then all your stoker controls. You guys can always pause if you want to read some of that. Pretty cool. And of course you got your firebox doors. And they said the operating temperature inside of this cab was 30 degrees warmer than the typical outside temperature. So, pretty hot job here. You can see the sight feed and lubricator. Pretty cool. Still has all its original controls and everything, so you can get a real good idea of how it works. And here's a little plaque they have with some information on it. But it definitely is a pretty massive locomotive. There's your automatic brake valve right there. And the reverse lever. Pretty cool. They definitely didn't care too much about their comfort, that's for sure. These seats are pretty Spartan, but train control warning whistle, and then this thing here goes to the bell up front. We can probably hear it if I pull it. Yeah, the conductor's signal whistle right there. You can see that right there, actually. But pretty neat. And you can even look inside the tender here. 28 tons of coal. It'll be in this hopper in here, and you got your little worm gear in there that would feed it. And then it also carried 25,000 gallons of water behind that as well. But yeah. Pretty interesting, that's for sure. And they've got a little skylight sort of up there so they can ventilate in here and let some of that heat escape. But I thought you guys would like to look around in here. Go back outside here. Alright. Anyway, guys, I thought you'd find that interesting. I'm going to keep looking around, see what else they have, and I'll see you later.